Tim Dodd, the Everyday Astronaut, here to explain why SpaceX's recent reuse of a rocket is perhaps the biggest thing to happen in 21st century spaceflight, and why this launch may go down in the history books as a defining moment in human history. We take you behind the scenes of this historic launch, and we go right up close and personal with SpaceX's now famous, twice flown Falcon 9 rocket, Core 21. Let's get started.
3, 2, 1, 0, 10.
Rockets! I'm about a quarter mile away, I don't know, maybe half mile away, some distance away from SpaceX's Falcon 9 rocket.
That is the coolest rocket, and possibly the most historic rocket that's going to be launching at least anytime soon. This is SES-10, which is SpaceX reusing the exact same first stage booster that first flew on CRS-8. I am super stoked. Let's do this!
Ooh, I like rockets.
We're at T-minus 1 hour on the clock, and all systems are go. That is fantastic, because this Falcon 9 is ready to fly again. That's right, I said it, again.
Liftoff of Falcon 9, the world's first reflight of orbital class rocket. Falcon 9 has cleared the tower.
It's an amazing day, I think, for space as a whole, for the space industry. You can fly and refly an orbit class booster, which is the most expensive part of the rocket. This is going to be ultimately a huge revolution in spaceflight.
I think we're really going to look back at this moment in time and go, remember when we used to throw rockets away? Well, as of today, we don't. Okay. So was this really that important, or is this all just a bunch of hyperbole? Was that Falcon 9 powered by a bunch of onions? Or why did a flying piece of metal make this 32-year-old man-child shed a little tear? I think in order to understand why this is so revolutionary, let's take a look at what NASA thought the near future would look like back in 1970.
The vehicle is called the Space Shuttle, an airliner-like spacecraft capable of over 100 trips from Earth into Earth orbit.
The space shuttle was meant to make trips to space cheaper and more routine. And although it was really iconic and beautiful, it ended up actually being the most expensive way to get things into space. Whoops. Let's compare the cost of getting things to space on different rockets to get a better sense of how expensive spaceflight is. Let's say you want to send 1 kilogram, or 2.2 pounds, or perhaps a large pepperoni pizza to space. If you were to send that pizza up on a space shuttle, it would have cost you about $19,824. That's one steep delivery fee. If you were to use another very common rocket known as the Atlas V, it would cost you about $8,345. But if you were to use a SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket, which is currently about the cheapest way to get something into space, it would cost you about $2,719. And that's with a brand new rocket. SpaceX claims they can bring that cost down by about 30%, or to about $1,930, once these reused rockets become a normal thing. That's awesome. So when do we expect this to become a normal thing? Is this going to be another space shuttle promise that in 30 years we'll look back with a little disappointment? Well, time will tell for sure, but things are looking very promising. Elon Musk claims their next goal is to have rapid reuse of boosters by the end of the year. Their goal is to go from landing to refueling and flying within 24 hours. It's a lofty goal, but so far SpaceX has proven over and over their ability to achieve the once thought impossible. So when it's all said and done, what's all this mean? Why am I so excited? By making access to space cheaper, a whole new economy will boom. We're about to see everyday people going on trips to space in the near future, as well as things like asteroid mining, moon bases, floating space hotels. The future we were promised is just on the horizon. This also means things like better GPS, faster internet, better weather observation satellites, and exciting scientific discoveries are going to be that much cheaper and easier to roll out, which is awesome for everybody. When rockets become as reusable as airplanes, going to space will become about as thrilling as visiting your aunt in Arizona.
Sorry, Shirley.
Make sure and hit subscribe for more fun, funny, and factual content. A huge shout out to my Patreon supporters for helping make this road trip all the way down to Florida, it was a 21-hour trip, possible. If you want to help crowdfund this show and other Everyday Astronaut content, please visit patreon.com/everydayastronaut.
Thank you.
Let me know what other comments or questions you have about rockets or space in the comments below. Well, that does it for me. I'm out of here. I'm Tim Dodd, the Everyday Astronaut, bringing space down to Earth for everyday people.